to life, come unto me. Sing in my heart all the stirrings of compassion. Blow in the wind, rise in the sea, move in the hand, giving life the shape of justice. Roots hold me close, wings set me free. Spirit of life, come to me, come to me.
Creator of the world, Holy One, we have come from many places to this place, this safe place of community. God with us, on journeys of our own to a place where journeys meet. So here in this safe place, let us take time together. For when paths cross and pilgrims gather, there is much to share and celebrate. In your name, come, let us worship. May it be so.
I have called you by your name, you are mine. I have gifted you and ask you now to shine. I will not abandon you, all my promises are true. You are gifted, called and chosen, you are mine. I will help you learn my name as you go. Read it written in my people, help them grow. Pour the water in my name, speak the word and so claim. Offer Jesus' body given long ago. I know you my touch as you go. Feel it pulsing in creation's ebb and flow. Like a woman reaching out, choosing faith in spite of doubt. Hold the hem of Jesus' robe, then let it go. I have given you a name, it is mine. I have given you my spirit as a sign. With my wonder in your soul, make my wounded children whole. Go and tell my precious people they are mine.
Please be seated and join with me in the opening prayer. Together, God of our journeying, inviting us to travel with you, forgive us when we cling to outworn security, afraid to let go of what is safe and familiar. Give us courage to take the risk of answering your call into joyous journeying and adventures. May it be so.
Breathe on me, breath of God, fill me with life anew, that I may love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on me, breath of God, unto my heart is pure.
Can I ask the young folks to come forward, and anybody else who feels young and would like to come forward? I'm going to ask all these other young folks that are also sitting behind you some questions. So all of you, I'm going to ask you some questions. Did you help, if your hands up, if you help around the house when you were younger? Hands up if you cleaned your room. Hands up if you helped maybe with the dishes. Hands up if you maybe set the table. And I'm sure there was all kinds of other things that we did when we were younger to help out around the house. Well, Samuel goes to God's house. And he's going to live there with a man called Eli. And he has to help out. He's got two things he has to do. At 6 o'clock at night, he's got to close the doors to the sanctuary. It gets dark at 6 at night. He then, and in the, if you look at your the bulletin, at the front of the bulletin, you'll find that there's a lamp. It's called the lamp of presence. I went looking for one. I asked Gabrielle, I asked Graham, I asked Barb. I know that Ian used to have one and couldn't find one, so Graham put one on the leaflet. It's called the lamp of presence. We don't know how many they were, but they were on a candelabra, and they kind of held the oil lamps like this. There might have been seven of them, there may have been eight, we don't know. But Eli had to make sure that that lamp never went out. From 6 o'clock at night until 3 o'clock in the morning. That was his job. So he had to listen because they would sometimes make a sputtering noise if they were going out, and he'd have to get up and put more oil in, or he'd have to cut the wick back. Now, could you imagine from 6 at night to 3 in the morning, there's no TV, there's no radio, there's no iPhone, there's no computer, there's no Pac-Man. He has to stay awake and listen to make sure the lights don't go out. And then just before 3 o'clock, just as the sun's coming up, he's got to go outside and open the door to the sanctuary. We've got jobs to do at home that help out our family. Thank you, Jesus, that you give us tasks to do that can help out everybody in the family. Thank you, Jesus, and continue to give us tasks to do as we love you and love our family. In Jesus' name, amen.
Breathe on me, breath of God, until I am wholly thine, until this earthly part of me glows with thy fire divine. Breathe on me, breath of God, so I shall never die, but of thine eternity.
The bulletin gives a psalm reading after the Samuel reading, but we are not using that this morning. So the reading is just the reading from 1 Samuel, chapter 3, verses 1 to 10.
And the psalm, please.
Pardon?
And the psalm, please.
You know, I deliberately asked him what all he wanted of the readings for today, and he said, no, just that.
Do you have it?
Yes, sir, I have it.
I apologize.
Thank you. Apology accepted. All right. Following on from the discovery time, which was very illuminating, story. All right, so 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 1. Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was. And then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am." And he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up, went to Eli, and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son. Lie down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again a third time, and he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." And then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore, Eli said to Samuel, "Go, lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." And from Psalm 139, verses 1 to 6 and 13 to 18. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end. I am still with you. Hear what the Spirit is saying in these words of Scripture. Amen.
Thank you, Helen, and again, my apologies for misunderstanding. I'd like to begin with these words from Master Eckhart. He was a German mystic. He lived between the years of 1260 and 1328. This is what he said: "Apprehend God in all things, for God is in all things. Every single creature is full of God and a book about God. Every creature is a word of God. If I spend enough time with the tiniest creature, even a caterpillar, I would never have to prepare a sermon. So full of God is every creature." Does the butterfly remember that once was a caterpillar? What does God remember when she calls you? The story of Samuel's call is a wisdom story. God calls, and the message to us is that it's the weak ones, the wounded ones, the very young, the very old, the confused, and the lonely ones who are called by God to be God's presence to others. Rabbi Jesus knew this, and he knew Samuel's story and its wisdom, and Rabbi Jesus built on it with the parables about God being there for the lost, the least, and the littlest. So who are the folks in our story? Well, there's Hannah, who is Samuel's mom, Eli, a judge and a priest of Israel, and we're told that he's losing his eyesight, a polite way of saying both that his eyes are growing dim, a polite way of saying both that he's losing his eyesight, he's probably got cataracts, but he's also losing touch spiritually with God. Hannah is barren, prays to God for a child, and finds out she is pregnant. She prays Hannah's prayer, which we find in 1 Samuel. And scholars believe that that prayer became the basis for Luke's Magnificat. Hannah gives birth to Samuel. The text tells us when Samuel was weaned, he'd be given to Eli in God's service. When are we weaned? When are we weaned? When we no longer need the breast. Does that mean that this man who's in his late 70s is going to receive a 3-year-old? He can't even be responsible. Eli can't even be responsible for his own sons who are priests in the sanctuary. His own sons are a scandal to the priesthood. They're abusing their office. They're seducing women as they come into the sanctuary for sexual exploitation. Sam Eli cannot even control them. So how is he going to control a 3-year-old kid who's running around the sanctuary? When you're weaned, you're about 3 years old. And up until last week, I always thought that Samuel was just dropped off with Eli when he was 3. Well, I was mistaken. I got that wrong. In ancient Israel, the expression weaned had a totally different meaning. You were weaned when you passed from being a child to taking on more adult responsibilities. Children were considered weaned between the ages of 6 to 9 years old. At age 6, for example, if you took on being a shepherd and shepherding duties, you were considered weaned. If you took on duties around the farm, the house, you were considered weaned. Girls were considered weaned when they hit puberty if they hadn't taken on other adult responsibilities around the house. Samuel was given to Eli weaned when he was 9 years old. And he took on adult responsibilities of closing the door, opening the door, and making sure that the lamp of God never went out. Trimming the wicks, ensuring there was enough oil. And scripture tells us, now the boy Samuel ministered to the Lord before Eli, and the word of the Lord was rare in those days. There was no widespread revelation. Eli's lost it spiritually. He's lost it because he can't control his own sons. And the word of the Lord was rare because the people had got hardened in their hearts. And his eyes were dim, and he was spiritually lost. So at the age of 12, just before dawn, that time of the morning when light breaks through, the sun is not yet up. The time of the morning when Mary and the other women went to the tomb and found that the stone was rolled away from Jesus' tomb. The sun's not yet up. Light is slowly taking over the darkness. The time of day that reminds us of when God created light. For God said, "Let there be light." And God cloaked herself in a white shawl and dashed across the heavens. And the light of God's glory spread out behind, and that gave us the light of creation. That time of the morning when the sun is not yet up, the birds are starting to sing, and it starts to get light and reminds us of the light of creation. And God calls to a 12-year-old boy, a 12-year-old boy. And God spoke to Samuel, and Samuel answered, "Here I am." Samuel was so impressed by what he heard, he responded by saying, "Here I am." This is a beautiful way to respond to God's word. It isn't that God doesn't know where we are, but it tells God and reminds us we are simply before God as servants, asking what God wants us to do. Samuel is among several others who also said, "Here I am," when the Lord spoke to them. Abraham, Jacob, Moses, Isaiah, Ananias. Later this morning, we'll be singing a hymn with the words, "Here I am, Lord." How do we respond and how do we understand that phrase? "Here I am, Lord." What do we mean? What are we saying to God? What are we acknowledging to ourselves and to others in the community? When we sing it, it's appropriate sometimes to raise our hands in prayer. Maybe raise our hands like this. If you feel comfortable to do that, please do that as we sing, "Here I am, Lord." We also heard part of Psalm 139 this morning. "For you yourself created my inmost parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I thank you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, my soul knows well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret and woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my form as yet unfinished. Already in your book were all my members written. As day by day they were fashioned, when as yet there were none of them. How deep are your counsels to me, O God? How great is the sum of them? If I count them, they are more than numbers in the sand, and at the end I am still in your presence." The sages and the rabbis taught that Adam, earth creature, the one that was formed from the earth, the dust of the stars, just like you and I, before his name became Adam, spoke this psalm, but David wrote it down. Scripture tells us, "Then God formed Adam, earth creature, from the dust of the stars and the ground, and breathed into Adam's nostrils the breath of life, and Adam became a living being." Adam had his "Here I am" moment, came to life, stood up, and spoke Psalm 139. "Here I am, Lord, for you know me and you form me in the earth's womb." Here I am, Lord. This is a beautiful way to respond to God. It isn't that God does not know where we are, but it tells God and reminds us we are simply before God as servants, asking what God wants us to do. And we all have a servant ministry. We all serve. All service is ministry. We know what our gifts are. For like Samuel, we have wisdom to respond appropriately to the call. We know what our gifts are. We know how to use them for the greater community, the work of the church, the work of justice and peace, the work of the world. We know what we're good at and what we're not good at. Every time I've been interviewed by a parish to come and be their minister, I always said, "I have gifts, and the one thing I do not know and understand and I'm not going to get involved with, I have no idea how to read a spreadsheet. Don't ask." When I was asked to be the chairperson of St. Michael's Center, the first thing I said to them was, "I will do the job, but somebody else has to sit on the finance committee because that was supposed to be one of the roles of the chairperson. And don't bother trying to explain a spreadsheet to me. You can do that till the cows come home. I have no idea." So somebody else took over that job, and I became on the board, because I knew there was no point in me doing that, because it just went, whoosh. I did not comprehend. It was not one of my gifts. So we all have gifts, whether it's being on a committee, whether it's being present, whether it's holding a friend's hand and not saying anything, whether going through a crisis in their life, whether it's sitting down every day and holding up this community in prayer. That is a gift of ministry. It's a way of our saying, here I am, Lord. Whatever we do as a response to God's call. Here I am, Lord. God called to Samuel. It's a wisdom story. And wisdom consists in doing the next thing we have to do, doing it with your whole heart and finding delight in doing it. Wisdom consists in doing the next thing you have to do, doing it with your whole heart and finding delight in doing it. So whom does God call? She calls the weak ones, the wounded ones, the very young, the very old, the confused, and the lonely, the doubters and the fearful, the hopeful and the blessed. You and me, who are called by God to be God's presence to others. We are a collective and personal, here I am, Lord. Be that beautiful response. May we have wisdom in doing the next thing you have to do, doing it with your whole heart and finding delight in doing it. Does the butterfly remember the caterpillar it used to be? Yes. Scientists at UBC have been able to prove that. What does God remember when she calls us? God remembers that we are the beloved, formed from the dust of the stars, given life, loved, blessed, and called into service with the wisdom to respond, here I am, Lord. May it be so.
All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him, in his presence daily live. I surrender all, I surrender all to thee. Savior, I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender. Make me, Savior, wholly thine. Let me feel thy Holy Spirit. Truly know that thou art mine. I surrender all, I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender, Lord, I give myself to thee. Fill me with thy love and power. Let thy blessing fall on me. I surrender all, I surrender all.
Hello and welcome. I'm recording this Prayers of the People on behalf of my wife Tammy, who is sick, and I personally am on a plane at this time heading for Winnipeg for a conference next week. So you get the virtual me. Let's begin. Loving God, creator of all things new, we give thanks for the gift of today. We give thanks for the freshness and the scents of the blooming flowers, the rainbow of colors blossoming in the season where there is such an abundance of new life. We ask you to help us to protect and care for this sacred planet. We pray for Reverend Graham and Gabrielle and all those who are meeting in the regional meetings this weekend. We pray in thanksgiving for the gift of having Randolph Bruce here with us. And we give thanks for Sean, Mira, Victor, Casey, Andrew, Barb, and Steve, and for the many volunteers in our congregation who help to breathe life and structure into this church community. We pray for the students and the teaching staff in this final busy month of school. We pray for families who are struggling with how to fill the summer months and how to balance childcare and work responsibility when the school will be closed. We pray for all people who are stretched financially, facing food and housing insecurity, living in this beautiful but expensive city, that there will be enough resources to help them to stay well and make ends meet. We pray for the missing and murdered Indigenous women and girls and for those who ache for them. We pray for peace and for justice. We pray for all those lives who are impacted by addiction, for those struggling with addiction, for those who love them, and for the first responders. We pray for peace and for healing. Now we take a moment to lift up to you those who we carry in our hearts who are struggling with health issues. We pray for peace for them, their families, friends, and care providers. We also pray for world leaders. We pray that they will use their powers to lift up the oppressed and be the leaders who will understand and make decisions based on the sacredness of life and of all human beings. For reporters, we ask that you help them lift us up with stories of hope and to minimize the sensationalized stories of deceit and despair that can take us away from believing in your beauty manifested through others in the world. Help each one of us to move out of our comfort zones, to reach out to those in need. Help us to have the eyes and the hearts to see the beauty and value in those who are different from us, to treat all people with kindness and respect. Help us to be the signs of light and love in our beautiful broken world. Amen. And now we proceed with the Lord's Prayer.
Together, in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. May God's peace be with you. Let's share that peace with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Could we have the hymn, Here I Am, Lord?
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. I will dwell in deepest sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. I will bear my light to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them, whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord, it is I, Lord. I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them, my hand to save. Finest bread I will provide, to their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them, whom shall I say?
Life and work of the church. Bible study happens most Tuesdays on Zoom with the Reverend Dr. Dorothy Jeffrey. If you're not already on the list to get information about dates, times, and themes, please speak with Dorothy or get connected to her through the office. Thank you once again to the fundraisers for Sweet Sounds on Sussex. A good time was had by many, many people. Tuesdays at 10:30, come by and have a congregational drop-in in the Flex Room. All are welcome to join. Sunday, June the 9th at 1, you are welcome to commemorate the beginning of the centennial of the United Church of Canada here in our sanctuary. There are only 2 more weeks to shop at the thrift store before summer break. You're welcome to continue to bring donations, but please bring them a bit at a time. Just a friendly reminder that Monday night, Choir practice is on hiatus until September. Enjoy your summer, and we'll see you back in the fall. Our first Jubilee June Jamboree is taking place here at Sussex on Saturday, June 15th. You're welcome to come to hear some music entertainment, shop at some vendors, browse certain items from the thrift, including a book sale, buy some baking, and eat some concession items. If you want to volunteer, speak with Bonnie or Deborah, and if you are willing to do some baking for the bake sale, please speak with Linda. We celebrate together as a community this week. We celebrate the birthdays of Don S., Ken M., Indigo S., Elizabeth R., Jordan B., and Pablo A. Our offertory hymn.
Take what you offer, we will live by your word, we will love one another and be fed by you, Lord. We will take what you offer, we will live by your word, we will love one another and be fed by you, Lord.
Generous God, make us generous in your image. Make us compassionate in your image. Make us faithful in your image. Bless these gifts and all the gifts we offer, that your justice and peace may come on earth as it is in heaven. May it be so. Hymn, Just As I Am.
Just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, poor wretched blind, thy gracious healing of the mind, yes, all I need in thee to find, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, though tossed away.
May the blessing of the Creator, the eternal goodwill of the Creator, the shalom of the Creator, the wildness and the warmth of the Creator be among us and between us, now and always. May it be so.
Round the corner of the world I turn, one more about the world I learn. All the things that I see, you'll be looking at along with me. And it's from this old I travel to the new. Keep me traveling along with